Hello and welcome to Jan Sewing Solutions. Now there's a wonderful saying which states that you reap the rewards of what you sow, and that is so true. If you put something into, if you put the effort and the goodness into something, then that will reflect and that will show, and that's something that is a result of this wonderful suit that we recently stitched. Now, the reason why I quoted that quote at the beginning was what's been invested in this suit to get the result that you are looking at is two suits. They've been made for two young girls, two children. They're A-line camisa, but the whole the whole beauty of this suit is the investment that has been made in these. So initially what had happened was a customer bought in a lace. It was a wonderful, wonderful lace, exceptionally pretty, and she had paid quite a hefty price for it, but then it's reflective in the quality of the lace itself. It was £10 a meter, I think, and she just bought a small piece where she wanted this for her daughters. So what she requested was, can you please find something that will go with it? And I looked around and I said, well, she'd initially bought a linen fabric to go with this lace. And now I don't think her choice of fabrics is as good. And when I looked at the lace, I said, no, you do not want this kind of heavy lace on a linen fabric. You need a heavier fabric as well. So what we chose was the merino. This is a thick fabric and it's exceptionally comfortable. It's really good for winter and it doesn't crease. It does slightly fade out, but it doesn't bubble to the extent that you'd see lots of other, you know, woolen mix or thick fabrics. But it came in beautiful colors. I think it came in about 30 colors. It is on the repeat order, so it probably will be available again in the next couple of weeks. So you probably saw me stitching quite a few of my own suits in this. So if you look at any of my old videos, I think there's quite a few that I've done for myself. Now, when she bought this lace in, she was coming out with all sorts of what she wanted it contrasting. And obviously, to contrast this off with the large flowers, one, we had the problem of locating these particular colours because they're quite bold colours and often they're quite difficult to get. So instead, I had a perfect matching with the gold, so we went for the gold. Now, that's also very, very striking. And there's two things we've done. One, we've created the piping on the sides, and then we've done tarpai, because, and this is where the mehnat or the effort goes in, because it was such a beautiful suit, we wanted to put the effort into making the suit, because that's what was going to make it stand out. So when you invest in something like this, then do invest in the time to make this. It's not quantity, it's quality that counts. And often we make the wrong assumptions where we are going for quantity over quality. So always make a choice for quality over quantity, because quantity, well, there's two bits of advice that I would give you if you were going for whichever choice you were making. Firstly, if you are making something like this, which is for winter and which is going to be wash and wear clothing that you're going to use repeatedly, then the bit of advice that I would give you is choose the fabric wisely, choose your matchings wisely, and get it stitched nicely. Because you're going to wear it repeatedly, is going to be reflective on, you know, it's probably the one that you'll be seen in the most. So, you know, make a choice of quality over quantity. And now, if it's an item that you're going to wear maybe the once or the twice, and, you know, it's going to be a passing phase type of thing, then you can make a choice where it could be, you know, it doesn't matter what it's like. The fabric can be tatty because you're probably going to wear it the once or the twice, and before you know it, it's going to go out of date. Anyway, going back to this particular suit, I would say this is more of your quality rather than quantity. The neck, we've just used the lace and directly ironed it on using the wonder web, and it's actually, it doesn't look, because of the dark color, you can't actually see as well. I think it's more prominent on the hem because of the fact that it's a bigger border and it's been contrasted off with the color of the piping and the trim, so it's more apparent. But it is actually, even the neckline, it just looks like it's just embroidered on. I mean, there are wonderful designs that you can do with stuff like this. You can have lace like this going over in the center panel if you wanted, and then you can do kalidars, or you can do it on the hemlines. But the lace itself is absolutely wonderful. To use this kind of lace, you do need to use something like wonder web, because it's a cut work type of lace which you cannot stitch all the way around. And if you did not use wonder web, then you would have to stitch all the way around the, you know, and that would flatten the floral print of the embroidery, which will actually ruin it. So invest in some wonder web. It's a wonderful thing. And do you know what the beauty of it is? I've actually washed my suits that I used it on, and it has not moved at all. The glue is permanent. It's not something that, you know, after a wash it'll start coming up and you know, away. Even then, it's probably worthwhile just to tack this down as well. But that's where the patience of the owner of the suit comes in, not us, because we've already invested a lot of time in this, because we went and did tarpai, which is blind hemming all the way around, and as many of you will be aware, blind hemming is a task in its own. Now, with these dresses, we've made churidars, and that, you know, the result of these dresses is absolutely exceptional. If it wasn't for the fact that the lace wasn't enough, then I would have probably loved to have done some, maybe an arkali type of dresses in this. But it's expensive lace. You have to be careful on how you design the outfit if you were going to use lace like this. Also, another thing to bear in mind, if you use laces like this, then try and skip using it on the sleeves. I mean, here all we've done is use the two color combinations of fabrics on the sleeves, and on the sleeves that's fine, because often when you have laces and stuff, it rubs against the sides of your chemise, and often you can get bubbling on your garments due to the fact that there's wash and wear. You've probably seen often where people have had lots of heavy work on their sleeves, and then that's rubbed again. Even if it rubs against you, the side of your chemise, the ones your chemise will get ruined. So be careful on where you use it. Even using it on the hem of this dress, it's done it perfect justice. And inshallah, that's just one of examples of suits that we've just recently done. I am going to go on to show you some winter stock that's just arrived, so do watch the video. And if you would like to order, then go online and you can get these suits through the online shop as well. Unfortunately, the lace of this is something that's been purchased from elsewhere, but there are many good lace shops that you can buy laces like these from.